Hello everyone, welcome to SQL Depository, and this is module 7.2 where we are going to discuss another config file of Postgres, postgresql.auto.conf. So postgresql.auto.conf is the config file that overrides postgresql.conf file, which means if the parameter value is changed in postgresql.auto.conf, then it will override the parameter values in postgresql.conf. It works with alter system command, and the syntax is alter system set configuration parameter, and then you will have to provide the value. And to reset, you can write alter system reset the config parameter. And if you want to reset all the config parameters from postgresql.auto.conf, then you can use alter system reset all. So these are the commands, and this is how postgresql.auto.conf works. But let's go ahead and see it in our Postgres instance. Okay, so let me connect to Postgres. And as I've already told you that it works with alter system command. So what I'm gonna do is I will check the configuration, configuration value of work memory. It is 8 MB right now. And similarly, I will check the current configured value for shared buffers. Oops, my bad. There is a typo. Yes, so it is 64 MB right now. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna use alter system command to change the parameter values of these two PostgreSQL parameters, and then we will see how exactly it works. So I would write alter system work underscore mem is equals to 16 MB and enter. Okay, I forgot the keyword set. So let me actually go ahead and edit my command. And this time it was successful. So I would write another command for shared buffers, which is alter system set shared underscore buffers. And the value I'm gonna set is 128. So right now it is 64 MB, as you can see here. Right, so hit enter. Now both the commands are successful. So what I'm gonna do is I will check the values of these parameters in PG file setting table. Okay, so select star from PG underscore file underscore settings, where name is equals to work underscore mem, and hit enter. Here you can see two entries for work memory. One is for 8 MB, and that is coming from the main config file, which is postgresql.conf. And then there is another entry, which is coming from postgresql.auto.conf config file, and it is 16 MB, and the applied is true here. But is it seriously applied, or it is still waiting for something? As we already know that you will have to reload the config, configuration in order to make new value of work memory effective. So we will check work underscore mem, and it is still 8 MB. Similarly, we will check for shared buffers, and it is still 64 MB. But what about PG file settings table? So I will check PG file settings table for shared buffers as well. So for shared buffers also, it is 64 MB from the Postgres config file, and it is written, it is 128 MB in postgresql.auto.conf file, but it is not effective yet. Okay, so let me quit this. And now, to make new values effective, what I'm gonna do is I will have to reload the config file, and my new setting for work memory will be effective from there. But shared buffers will still require a restart, so it will not take effect until we will not restart our Postgres instance. But before doing this, I'm going to edit the conf file just to show you what exactly is written there. So I will copy the complete path. It is placed inside where lib Postgres 15 is the version number main, then the file name. So in the another terminal, I will have to connect it again. And now I'm connected. So I will use nano editor and then the path. And if I hit enter, there is nothing much written here, only the modified values, which are workmem to 16 MB and shared buffers to 128 MB. So how exactly this postgresql.auto.conf file works is, so whenever we start our Postgres instance, the first file, the first configuration file that will be loaded is postgresql.conf, and this is the file that will be loaded at the end. So whatever values has been modified in the postgresql.auto.conf file, it will overwrite the values inside postgresql.conf file. So this is how it works. And the use cases of this file is, if you don't want to touch your main config file, because if you'll do any mistake there, then there is a possibility that your PostgreSQL instance will not come up. So if you don't want to touch that configuration file, then you can always use alter system command to tweak the values of these parameters, and then it will override the values inside postgresql.conf. So I'm going to close this without saving because I did not do any change. And then I will go back to the another terminal. And what I'm going to do is I will write select star from pg underscore reload underscore conf, hit enter. Now the configuration has been reloaded. So this time if I'll run select star from pg underscore file underscore settings where name is equals to work underscore mem, and you will see that the value in the config file is 16 MB, which we have already seen. But if I'll run show work underscore mem, this time you can see the new value, which is coming from postgresql.auto.conf. But this will not be the case for shared buffer because we have just reloaded the configs, but we did not restart SQL instance, so it cannot be changed. So if I'll check shared buffers, it is still 64 MB. But what I'll do, I'll quit from here. I'm not gonna make any change in the main config file, which is postgresql.conf. I will just restart the Postgres instance, and then we will see the value of shared buffers. So for this, I will write sudo systemctl restart PostgreSQL. Okay, the password, and it should be done. Yeah, now it is done. I will connect to PSQL again, and then I will check the value of shared buffers. So shared underscore buffers, hit enter, and it is showing 128 MB now. Now, what if we want to revert those values? How exactly we can do that? So for this, the command is alter system reset. Okay, so earlier we were using set to change the value. Now we will use reset. So what I will write is alter system reset work underscore mem. Okay, so this is done. Now if I'll run select star from file underscore pg underscore file underscore settings where name is equals to work underscore mem, and you can see the entry for postgresql.auto.conf file has been has been removed. So if I'll run this command, which is so work underscore mem. Now still it is still showing 16 MB because we have not reloaded the configuration yet. So let me do that. For this I will write select star from pg underscore reload underscore conf and enter, and then if I'll check again, now you can see the old value which is coming from postgresql.conf. Okay, so we have reset the value for work mem. What about shared buffers? So we can reset the value of shared buffer also, so that it will not come from our postgresql.auto.conf file, but then it will require the restart again. Okay, so we can still do that, and once we will restart the Postgres instance, the value from postgresql.conf will take effect. Okay, and if you want to reset all the parameters that we have set in postgresql.auto.conf file, for this we will have to write alter system reset all, hit enter, enter. So now if I'll check the file again, now you can see nothing is written there. There is no parameter and there is no value that has been set here. So my postgresql.auto.conf file is empty after I have run reset all command. So this is how you can reset all the parameters from postgresql.auto.conf file. Okay, but if I'll check the value of shared buffers, it is still 128 MB. So let me go ahead and restart Postgres instance. So for this, I will write sudo systemctl restart PostgreSQL. And then I will connect to PSQL again, and then I will run the same command to find out the shared buffers value, and it is 64 MB now, which is coming from postgresql.conf file. Okay, so this is how we can use our postgresql.conf.auto.conf file to override the values of parameters from postgresql.conf file without even touching the config file. And if we don't want to write these values inside the postgresql.auto.conf file, it is always fine because we have the alter system command to do that. And you don't have to edit the physical file. You just write the command to set the values, and this is done. Then if it is, the parameter require the reload, do that. If it require restart, then do the restart. And the values from postgresql.auto.config file will take effect. So this is pretty much what I wanted to cover in this video. In the next video, we will discuss another config file.